Hello, my friends. Welcome to Trading with KS. So today is 9th of October 2021. So today we want to talk about the big picture, the global steel index, the oil, global oil price, the aluminium index, the semiconductor. We want to look at the local sector and see which one is the better sector to invest next week, right? We, of course, when we invest, we need to know where is the proper direction, right? As I said, right? Don't close your eyes and put the money there and think the money will grow for you. Okay? We have to do some homework. We want to know, at least we want to know where the place the money is growing. Don't throw the money at the place where the money is shrinking. Okay, let's check out the introduction first. Disclaimer, be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including without limitation to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metal, etc. carry a high level of risk and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs. Before we go into the analysis, I want to thank everyone again. I want to thank everyone again for buying me coffee. Of course, I started this coffee, buy me coffee initiative. So you guys, right, can buy me a coffee so that in the morning when I wake up, okay, before I do my homework and publish to you guys, okay, I can take a sip, a cup of coffee and enjoy the morning first, okay. So the site is here, right, ko-fi.com/tradingwithks. Okay, so you just can click here, okay, there are many links here, okay, you can buy me how many coffee up to you, okay, the amount is up to you, okay, this is USD, okay, so you can buy one cup, two cup, three cups, up to you, can buy to me 50 cup, 100 cup also, look, okay, if you don't buy also, it's okay, okay, because everything here is free, okay, I share to everyone, okay, if you appreciate, if you want to buy me a coffee, okay, tip me a coffee, thank you very much, okay, but remember, Facebook, YouTube is free, so anybody you know, or the spammer put in the comment there, okay, ask you to join this, pay money here, pay money there, at the comment section, okay, those are spammers, okay, so don't fall into the trap, okay. Okay, let's check out. I want to thank you guys first, okay. Yesterday, okay, already thank you guys for paying me. You also give me the virtual coffee, also fantastic. Okay, virtual coffee. Looking at it already. already want to, saliva also coming out, right? So we got this. Yesterday we got Ethan, you know, thank you Ethan, buy me coffee. We got Sam Loy, buy me coffee. Go, buy me coffee. Jay got Jaya, buy me coffee. Lily Leong, SM, and Kevin K, Vivi, Eve the Han, if I'm not. If I'm mistaken, thank you very much. And we got a lot more again today. Okay, thank you very much. I also post, now I started to post some of the posts. A lot of you guys ask me answer, okay, asking me an answer, right? So, you know, in YouTube, you cannot post the picture, right, on the YouTube comment there. Okay, so you guys ask me question. If I think I can do a chart analysis, I will post it here. Then I will reply you at the YouTube there, I post it here because this coffee we can add the, you see this one, right? We can post the picture, okay, the analysis and the picture here, okay, so make it very easy for everyone. So I want to thank Wong also. I got post today, Wong, and also Kion. Okay, today I got post Wong, Tech Berhad, Wong and Kion, and also I want to thank Go. Go bought me coffee. Cheng Chi Heng, thank you very much. Tang An Zhe, okay, thank you very much. HS, thank you very much. This one, Tang An Zhe, Chi Heng. This one anonymous, didn't leave the name. Thank you very much. And also Hazel, thank you, Hazel. David Papa, thank you very much. Wong Lok Kong, thank you very much. Fanny Young, thank you very much. Gabriel, thank you very much. So I got lots of coffee to drink, okay? Thank you everybody. Let's check out, okay, what are going on to the index, okay, the big picture next week. Okay, before that, we want to check out the global index first. Okay, let's check out aluminium. Okay, aluminium is strong, okay, still holding above this line, this channel top. Okay, we got a channel top over here. Okay, we got a channel over here. So aluminium actually broke through the channel, still holding above the channel. Holding above the channel means it's very strong, okay? So aluminium is still very strong, okay? So still looks good to continue go up. Look like a rebound over here. There's still some room, RSI still, I think RSI still can go up, okay? RSI volume still big. RSI retrace a bit, rest a bit, okay? Consolidate, rest a bit now, pumping up, okay? Aluminium is still good, okay? Aluminium is still good, So look at, Nasdaq. Okay, Nasdaq got some rebounds, but not very strong. The price is still below the, still haven't break out. Still don't see, it's still on a downtrend correction. So this is still got dark cloud on the head. Haven't go through yet. Okay, you need to go through 15158. Only we will think that, okay, this got a big chance to, okay, go up. When this continue, you need to go through here first. Okay, if we go through there, then they will be good. Okay, good for our technology. Now technology is 50-50. I don't see it very strong, but I don't see it very, very weak. Okay. SOX. Okay, SOX. Remember, we draw what do we draw here? Resistance line, right? This is I say very important place where it should not break down. If technology stock semiconductor want to continue up, right? It should not go down here. Okay, it should not. Okay. So today, you see last week, right? It broke down, okay? It broke down and it tried to go back up, cannot. Now it continue come back down. You see what happened after the broken support? What happened? It's become resistant, right? You see the price came back here again, tested it, came back down, okay? So this is already established this one as a resistant already. So now it's very difficult for the price to go up anymore, okay? So every time that it go here, it will get, okay? Kick back down by this one, okay, the 3339. Okay, so semiconductor is still not out of the woods, okay, it's still in danger, okay. So if you hold a lot of semiconductor stock, if those are not performing and not losing money, not performing, maybe let go first. If you have those stock that can really make money, already gain one, means it's okay, still can keep, no problem. But those are lose already, those are starting to lose money, or those lose a little bit, maybe you want to be careful first, okay? If this one continue to drop, if you see your stock, okay, starting to drop, then maybe, okay, before starting to drop to cut loss area, then maybe you want to cut first, okay? This is not very strong. It's RSI also below 50, so it is not very strong. RSI already dropped below 50. So you see when the market is strong, RSI very rarely go down 50 one. Now you see RSI never went back this low before, right? For long time, right? You see, for starting from June, July, okay, onwards, from here onwards, okay, from May, June onwards, right? Okay, it just dipped too little bit only below 50. Okay, now it's very far below 50, so this is not very strong, but let me see. Oh, but if you got all those semiconductor stock, technology stock that, not performing or not making money, not losing money, maybe I would let go first. Okay, take the money, go chase the right wind first. Chase the money where the go put yourself into the direction where the money is growing. Okay, you know where the money is growing. Later we check out the sector. Still is still the bears. You see the bears and the bull, right? We draw the line here, right? And it's exactly is a place where, okay, where the bulls, okay, supply and demand, the bulls and the bears is fighting like crazy, right? So you see we draw a line here long time ago, right? Okay, so we spotted the exact point where is the turning point. Okay, turning point means if the price, okay, struggle to go through, if the price got one big rebound over here, means it is going up. Okay, if we got one break down here, means it is going down. Okay, so going down, we are not playing still anymore. If we got a big rebound up, we will still hold all the steel stock. Okay, so this one is still, we don't know yet. Still fighting with each other. The bulls and the bears are still equal. Okay, so you see exactly at the line that we already marked, very, very important. Okay, so you see exactly they are fighting there. Okay. So we have to, this one still have to wait. Crude oil. Okay, crude oil already broke through already. Okay, very strong. That day I said crude oil still can keep. You see crude oil now continue up again. Okay, so there's a possibility that crude oil can still continue up. So oil stock still hold, no problem. Metal ETF. So metal ETF is still going to this downtrend channel, not very strong. Metals is still not very strong. We want, most likely, once this one steel, okay, this one, the steel and metal index already show the direction up or show the right direction down, maybe this one, okay, will follow. Because I said Malaysia one is more, this one is more influence, okay, the influence is higher on this one. Steel and metal product index is more, the influence is higher than this one, the XMB. Okay, so let's go into the local index. Okay, local index, you see consumer actually rebound already, making a higher high. Okay, means consumer is strong now. Okay, next week consumer is okay. Okay, next week consumer play is okay. Okay, the previous high is here. Okay, so it make a higher low and higher high already. Okay, means this one really established a okay, uptrend channel. Okay, means this is okay already. Okay, it's okay to continue go up. Okay, most likely it will sideways a little or it will break through and go up. So this one is okay. Okay, it's not bad. Okay, this is one of the place that I would, okay, invest. Okay, and RSI already above 50, right? RSI already above 50. Okay, so this is okay. Okay, consumer is okay. So we'll take a look at others. Okay, construction is not okay yet. Okay, construction is still okay going sideways here. Construction is still sideways here. It's still not rebound yet, but consumer has rebound. Okay, construction I'm not keen yet. Okay, until it can go out of here, okay, go out of 166, above 166, then maybe we want to play this. Okay, and you see RSI, okay, is below 50. Okay, RSI is below 50, right? RSI below 50. So this one not strong yet. Okay, to play, not strong yet. Okay. Energy. Okay, energy rebound. Okay, it went through the previous high already. So energy is quite strong. Okay, the previous high is here. Okay, so the previous high is here. Okay, so it break through previous high. Okay, so still can hold. Okay. But it's still got a dark cloud over here, okay, the top of the channel over here. There's one more line over here that you need to break to remain long-term bullish. Now it's only short-term, okay, short-term play. So it's still got this one to break. Once you break out of this, above this, then it's very blue sky. Okay, now there is still dark cloud, but short-term is still okay. So that's why I said short-term you still can hold, but long-term is still got a dark cloud up there. Still got a dark cloud here. Okay, at around 80 is a dark cloud, means it cannot penetrate to 80, it might come back down.
If we go through 80 means blue sky all the way that should be. 80 is very high. Okay. So, but still okay. Short term still okay. Okay. Still okay. Finance still struggling. Okay. Still slowly going down. There's no rebound. Okay. There's no rebound. We didn't see any big rebound yet. So it's still struggling. At a sideways, okay, struggling sideways. So we haven't seen a higher high. Okay, so this one is okay, nothing to talk about lah. Nothing to brag about. Plantation. So plantation after the big jump, right? You cannot expect it. You need a breather, lah. As I said, lah. After you do a 100 meter, a 1 kilometer sprint, right? Okay, sprint not 100 meter, 1 kilometer walk. 1 kilometer walk, you still can go. But 1 kilometer sprint, you're tired already. You have to take a breather here. Okay, and okay, as long as you see, is resting above this channel. Okay, 16, this previous high. Okay, 6775. As long as resting here, okay, then another burst will be very strong. Okay, if it rests, come back down here, then okay, this could be very careful. Okay, we need to be very careful. This one, once you go back into channel, this one become a false break. False break means it could just oscillate here, similar to here, right? Okay, it cannot go through, right? You see, it cannot go through, it come back down, okay, oscillate here. So hopefully it don't go back down 6775. Okay, if it doesn't go back 6775, okay, then the next push, right? Okay, the next push will be quite strong. Okay, will be strong. This one still okay. Okay, okay to hold. Property, so property slightly rebound, okay, but still not very very strong. Okay, property slight rebound, higher high, yes, it make a higher high. Okay, so there is a channel over here, you can see already. Okay, it's making a uptrend channel here. Okay, but this is not as strong as consumer. Okay, because it still got this problem, okay, it still got this long term channel to break inside. Okay, so there is dark cloud, still dark cloud here. Okay, a dark cloud here. So it still need to go inside before, okay, before it got big momentum to continue. Okay, if we can break inside, then okay, it's game on. If we cannot break inside, okay, I'm 50-50 on this, 50-50. So I'm not too bullish yet on this. Okay, but this one is not too bad. Okay, not too bad. Looks okay lah, but not as good as consumer. Logistic. So logistic big push up. Okay, we talked about logistic few days back. So logistic, we say what we said about logistic, right? Okay, logistic, if we can push through the high over here, right, definitely is very strong. Okay, remember I talked about here, right? Okay, it cannot push through. It came here, cannot push through. So this time it came here, push through. Okay, so this one definitely bullish, because it went up so high, right? It might come down a while, adjust a while before it go up, So stock, okay, or index doesn't like go up like that one, Or it go up in wave one, in wave, like that, okay. So there could be another wave here, okay, before it goes up again, okay. As long as it don't drop back below 900, okay, it should be okay. So this one is one of the strongest lah, the most bullish lah, you can say most bullish sector lah, compared to all the others. Plantation, healthcare, I said, okay, I don't talk about healthcare for quite some time. Of course I talk about healthcare, I don't play healthcare for long time. Okay, as I said, 2503 we marked here last time, right, after the drop. Okay, we say any rebound don't jump in the trap, right? Because the institution is playing ping pong, okay. So we will, when institution playing ping pong, okay, the retailer will get hurt. Okay, any rebound, okay, is opportunity for them to sell down. Any rebound is opportunity to sell down, so don't go into the trap. Okay, we want proper, okay, went up above 2703, proper wave, going up wave, then only we want to go in. We hear bullish news about glove price going up. Okay, US Bloomberg saying that we expect, okay, finally we think that the glove price will go up, okay, due to this and we see JP Morgan say Finally, I think it hit the rock bottom already. Okay, this time it might go up. When we see that news, only read, hear the news, don't go in, you know. Check this one, the chart, make sure the chart tell you. Okay, news can be manipulated, but data don't lie. Okay, means chart don't lie. Only if you know how to interpret the chart or not, you need to learn the technique to interpret the chart. Technology. Let's see technology. So our technology is there is a little trouble over here. Double top. This could be a double top, so be careful. As far as the chart goes now, technology is still okay. Okay? Technology is still okay. It broke through this high over here. This is the danger that I said. Okay, if it cannot break through, okay, it come back down, then it's a danger. But it really broke through. Came back and retest, then consult. Confirm that this one is the support already. Means whenever it come back down here, right? Okay, very likely it will get the push up. Okay, very likely it will get the push up. Okay, so this one is still okay lah. Bullish or don't bullish or not? If next week it can go through here. Means it will go up again. If it cannot go through, maybe I think it will sideways here for a while. This one we have to see, but this one is okay. It's okay. It's not bad. Okay, technology is okay. So but there's a level here that is there's a level here that it got problem going through. Okay, there's a level here that it got problem going through. Okay, market 97.19. Okay, if it can go through 97.99, means it's want to continue to go up. If it cannot go through 97.19, then maybe it got will sideways for a while. Okay. But this one is still on an uptrend. It's still in a healthy uptrend. Still okay lah. So our semiconductor is still okay. Our technology is still okay. Industry. Okay, industry is still strong. Okay, industry is still good. Okay, it's still good. Breakout, retest, resumption, retest the top over here again. So it retest, confirm this one as a support again. It retested here. Okay, so it got support over here. Okay, continue to go up. So no problem. This one still okay. Okay, still a good sector to play. Okay, as long as the price stay above here. 202. Okay, as long as the price stay above 202, okay, shouldn't be a big problem. Okay. So looks like it's still good. There's a resistance line over here. Still got some time to go before it reach the resistance. Okay. So there's still some time to go before it reach the resistance. So there's still a gap. Okay, a gap for it to play. Yeah. Okay, there is a gap before it reach the dark cloud. There is a dark cloud over here. Okay. Because this whole trend actually fall out. You see this whole trend, right? Okay, this was the channel, right? Actually, it did fallen out of the channel. Okay, now it's trying to go back inside the channel. If it go back inside the channel, fantastic. Okay, if it cannot go back, the channel bottom will be the resistance to push it down. So it will be reaching there soon. Okay, it will be reaching there in a few days. Okay, still okay lah for now. Until it reach somewhere here, somewhere around 215, 214, then there will be pressure. Okay, there will be some pressure. So for next week, I think still okay. For next week, still okay. Telecom. So telecom is still downtrend, nothing much to play except of com. And red tone also got some push, but not for now, it's too late to go in. Okay, what else did I miss? I missed this. Remember to subscribe to my channel. Okay, you guys like my channel. Please subscribe to my channel. And if you're first time checking out my channel, every day at 7 to 8 p.m. I will upload. Okay, two video, one Chinese and one English. Every trading day. Okay, one Chinese and one English. Same content. And also I will any goodies. I will. Post on my Facebook during lunchtime and Twitter trading VKS during lunchtime. Remember, pump up the like for me and share this with your friend. And now we got one more extra feature, which is coffee.com. Okay, you guys can actually buy me coffee. Okay, going to this website, coffeeko-fi.com/tradingwithks. Okay, you can sponsor me coffee. Okay, with your PayPal account or with your credit card account. Okay, any amount is okay lah. This is not compulsory. I'm not saying that. Oh, you must buy me coffee or else I won't talk to you anymore. No such thing. Okay, my Facebook, my YouTube is all free. Okay. So see you again tomorrow. We are going to talk about all the stock we discussed this week. Okay, we are going to talk about oil stock. We are going to talk about some of the consumer stock. We are going to talk about Asia Agenda. Huatai drop already. Okay, Huatai tomorrow. We're going to take a revise one time on Huatai. We're going to talk about plantation. We're going to see the development of Sime, THF, replant, all these. See what is the individual stock doing. Then we are going to revisit the Maybach freight, the dialogue or Yinsen, or see what is the development after we talk about it. Of course we want to continue see the progress. Okay, so we will talk it in the end of the week to make sure that okay to track that how is the progress of the stock that we already discussed. Okay, whether we want to ever take profit, okay, or whether we want to cut loss, anything. So we want to at least okay track the initial starting progress. Because I cannot track every stock every week. I talk about so many stock. Okay, if I track it every week, after that you have to track it, because I already show you where is the cut loss, where is the take profit area. So you have to track it yourself. Okay, so see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we have a lot of things to talk about. Okay, Asia Saipal Agenda, Kim Loan, TDM, Sime Plantation, KLK, Huatai Asia, Amada Dayang, Hing Yuan, so all these are. Okay, thank you, and thank you for your contribution. Thank you for your coffee. Stay safe from COVID. Bye-bye.